Salve Regina,
Mater misericordiae, vita dulcedo, estes nostra salve.
Alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus again, in reply, spoke to the chief priests and elders of the people in parables, saying, "The kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who gave a wedding feast for his son. He dispatched his servants to summon the guests to the feast, but they refused to come. A second time he sent out other servants, saying, 'Tell those invited, behold, I have prepared my banquet. My calves and fatted cattle are killed, and everything is ready. Come to the feast.' Some ignored the invitation and went away, one to his farm, another to his business. The rest laid hold of his servants, mistreated them, and killed them. The king was enraged and sent his troops, destroyed those murderers, and burnt their city. Then the king said to his servants, 'The feast is ready, but those who were invited are not worthy to come. Go out therefore into the main road and invite to the feast whom you find.' The servants went out into the streets and gathered all they found, bad and good alike, and the hall was filled with guests. But when the king came in to meet his guests, he saw a man there not dressed in a wedding garment. And he said to him, 'My friend, how is it that you came in here without a wedding garment?' But he was reduced to silence. Then the king said to his attendants, 'Bind his hands and feet and cast him out into the darkness, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. For many are invited, but few are chosen.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
In this parable, the wedding garment was freely given by the king to all the guests. It was proof that they had accepted the invitation of the king. But one man refused to wear it, and this was a great insult to the king. So the man is bound and thrown out. It is a strong message that we cannot fool God. We have to become authentic followers of Jesus Christ. We can't do all the exterior things that look good, go to Mass, pray the rosary, even do great acts of charity, and to not have it transform our hearts and our minds. We can't just go through the motions. Be indifferent. We are not living in His will and think we can fool God, then we have serious problems. We think we are in charge. And it's interesting, this is the Gospel of Matthew. If we read earlier in the Gospel of Matthew, we hear the following from Jesus. "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' shall enter the kingdom of heaven, but he who does the will of my Father who is in heaven. On that day, many will say to me, 'Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in your name, and cast out demons in your name, and do mighty works in your name?' And I will declare to them, 'I never knew you. Depart from me, you evildoers.'" Dressing in the wedding garment means we give ourselves fully, wholeheartedly to Jesus and to the Father's will. It doesn't mean that we won't fail. We probably will. But it is an everyday surrender to His will, beginning again over and over, but with His help. Today we celebrate this beautiful feast, a continuation of last week's Feast of the Assumption, the Queenship of our Blessed Mother. The good news, when Mary, Mother Mary, is assumed into heaven, she is not just part of the furniture in heaven. She has an active role. And she wants us to join her and to join her Son permanently in heaven. She wants to help us. As she brought Jesus into the world, she wants to help us continually bring Jesus into every area, every aspect of our lives. So today on this great feast, the Queenship of our Blessed Mother, let us turn to her, let us ask her for her intercession to help us to truly wear the wedding garment that our Heavenly Father, our King, so lovingly, mercifully, and freely gives to us.
Regina Celi,
let us